ready for a day of chaos and fortune? It's game time.
I want to play a game.
Greetings, flesh bags, and welcome to The Cutting Room Locked and Loaded. This is a game show where we pit humans against each other in order to win some eyes. Goblin, show them the eyes. On the red team, we have Gorga. Gorga's hobbies include extreme snow sports and pretending they're from the 1920s. Tell me about your day.
Still going?
Sounds really interesting. They're joined by Jaden. Jaden is currently directing another RMITV show, 1700. What's your favorite color?
Red. My favorite color is red.
Clearly.
Also, it's Jaden. It's not whatever you said.
And on the blue team, we have Pot. He is an average comedian. Tell us about your beard.
I shaved my back, and then I glued it on my face.
I don't care. Pot is joined by Jamie. His motto is live, laugh, love. How did you spend your millionaire hot seat money, Jamie?
Robert, I bought the whole ocean. I bought some new clothes as well, this little number. Work in progress, otherwise.
Sounds dreamy. Clearly, you and Jaden both suffer from trichromacy. Oh. That's color blindness for you meatheads.
My bad.
Now it's time for Control Alt Delete. This is the game where I show you famous figures with their faces skinned off. You have to guess which meat monster it is. We'll show you four faces over 1 minute. Here is an example. The time starts now. Looks like Heroin Chic is back in style. Write down your guesses.
I don't know his actual name, but...
Oh, you don't know?
Well, I know what it is, but... He's Mexican, I know that much.
I am so totally pinning this look in my cottagecore mood board on Pinterest.
I can't remember which one he is.
You wrote it before, David.
Is that one?
You wrote it before.
No, that's
not
one. No. Oh, is it that one?
Yeah.
Okay. I haven't watched Team America in a long time, so.
Is it
not? That's my go to. Hey!
They're striking against AI. Watch, bitches.
You can jump in if you want, by the way. I feel like I know all the answers. You can do the last one.
Oh, really?
Go nuts.
No, oh my god, what the
hell? Pressure's on.
Is this 0.5?
Nah.
Good on you.
Okay, well, oh, yeah, that's what, yeah.
Looking good is in her jeans.
Do you reckon?
Her denim jeans. Ha ha. Ha ha.
Which one?
Oh. What?
Yeah,
or, like the singer Australian one, or like the one that married a singer?
I've changed my mind.
Okay.
Okay, now it's time to reveal
like, so
this year's New York Fashion Week runways.
Like she's hot.
Quiet, please. We'll start with image one. Red team, who do you have?
We have Mexican Congress alien.
And blue team, speak your answers.
Little alien guy?
Correct. The answer is the mummified alien corpse discovered in Mexico.
So you get a point for that?
Wait, who's right? I think we're right.
We had Mexico.
I said Mexico, I just didn't write it down, but we all heard it.
We're all thinking
it.
It's not true unless you wrote it.
He's also not called Little Guy.
Image two. Blue team, what did you have?
Oh, that's us. Kim Jong-un.
And red team.
You can read that if you want.
David Attenborough.
Yikes.
The answer is, my respected comrade, Kim Jong-un, supreme leader and international sex symbol, announcing the launch of North Korea's new nuclear submarines. Delicious. Now image three.
Good on them.
Red team, who did you have?
Cara Delevingne.
And blue team?
Margot Robbie.
The answer is, Margot Robbie, striking against AI. I protested against Barbie, so I guess we're even. Now, for the final image. Blue team, who did you have?
It was a bit of the old 50-50, but we went with Bella Hadid.
And red team?
We had Dua Lipa.
The answer is Taylor Swift.
Wow.
Yeah.
Looks like she's leaving the MTV Awards in a quick manner. Guess they should have called her Taylor Quick.
Oh. I'm getting a point.
How many did we get?
That looks like, oh.
Oh, hey, all right.
Yeah.
Yeah, show it up. Okay. Show off. We're winning. Let's brag.
What?
Okay, everyone shut up. Let's move on to nuclear reactions. I'm going to show you a viral video reaction, and you tell me what's getting these morons so excited.
I don't like it. I don't like it at all. No.
Goodness.
Right?
Red team, what do you think?
We think it is the old filter on TikTok that makes you look old.
And blue team?
Like a I think also the filter thing.
Okay, that, all right,
we can do that. But I'm gonna go with the filter.
What?
That's cheating, by the way.
I had it written down.
Yeah.
Wait, can we see that?
Oh, I lost the pen. Sorry.
The answer was Kyle Jenner in an old person filter.
Points this way. Thank you very much.
Oh, not yet? Okay.
Walk him over.
I don't like it. I don't like it at all. No. No.
Next video. All right. Ooh. Blue team, what did you think?
It's Chris Brown being nominated for an award, and Selena Gomez does not like that because he's a, you know, we know what he is.
And red team?
Well, obviously we all know Selena's a big Kanye fan, and Taylor Swift won an award at the VMAs, so she wasn't having it.
Ooh.
And the answer was Selena Gomez.
But that like fake clap as well.
Next video. I got the ghost, so I don't need a rose, but I might push a phantom that's right off the lot. I know I'm serving the father of time, and that's whether I got on a path. And red team, what do you think?
So obviously, youngest one here, I know who that is. That's Kai Cenat Giat Ohio reaction. And he's reacting to his friend that he's close with.
Blue team?
I mean, we didn't have an answer.
We're going to lock in one of those renegades we see this on TikTok. Maybe one of those.
Which one? He was watching The Strange Thing About the Johnsons by Ari Aster.
Have not seen it.
It's pretty gross.
The answer was... reacting to Doja Cat's music video, Demons.
He played in good faith.
It was like two girls, one cup, but...
Do I get points for the name?
And the scores are... blue team, 5 points. Red team, 2 points. Time to recharge. We'll see you after the messages.
Hi, I'm Jaden. Unlike all the other contestants here, which I found out were forced to be here, I came by choice. I was here to make friends and stuff, but apparently that's not the vibe we're going for. They gave us rooms to stay in. Everyone's calling Cage. I actually like it. I think it's nice. Better than what I usually have.
I see you're also wearing an interesting item of clothing.
Oh God, yeah.
What is the team?
So we're representing Chelsea over here, as you can see, in the Premier League. Chelsea's a team that plays, as you know. Up the Blues.
I hear you're directing 1700 this season.
I am directing 1700 this season. It's going to be the best season. We're actually going to have Taylor Swift on at the end of it, so stay tuned for that. Yeah, there's a boss in town, okay? That's all I'm going to say. We run a tight ship around here.
Incorrect.
Hi, my name's Georgia. I'm a current screenwriting student at RMIT, and I'm really nervous to be here right now because, like, RMIT is, you know, this really big production house, and it's really inspiring to me. And there's this one producer that I really love, and I'm really actually just here trying to ask her on a date, and her name's Claudia, and she's really beautiful, and she's really blonde, and she's really intimidating, and she makes me so nervous. Anyway, that's me, and I'm so happy to be here.
What is your favourite line from your favourite character from your favourite Shakespeare play?
Life is a dream.
Welcome back to Locked and Loaded. It's time for Macbeth Pro. In this segment, one player from each team will need to read a Shakespearean monologue about the latest news. Your team member must guess the story that inspired it. Incorrect guesses mean the other team gets a shot. First up is Jammy.
Blue team.
Jammy can't read.
Oh. Alrighty, and I'm gonna go right now. Are you ready, Pat?
I'm ready.
Oh, you better be.
I haven't read a newspaper in years, but I'm ready. Let's do it.
Ditto. Should I do a voice? I'm taking too long. Kim's first journey abroad in years, it seems, to meet with Putin, I fumbled already, of shared nuclear dreams. Yes.
Kim Jong-un went to Russia on a train and he had a secret meeting with Putin to discuss, I don't know, communist shit or whatever.
The answer is correct. Kim Jong-un's visit to Russia. Why did Kim Jong-un bring a jacket to Russia? Because even a dictator knows it's cold outside the comfort zone of the authoritarian regime. Okay, now for the red team to put their weak acting skills to use.
You got the right person for the job, don't you?
Don't worry. I'll show you, okay?
I'm sensing a pre-existing relationship.
Okay. Can I get started? Are you ready, Georgia?
I'm ready.
Okay. You a big Shakespeare fan?
Yep. Nice. I know all the plays.
Cool. O gentle souls, attend thine ears to me, a tale of a festival, a tragic spree. In Black Rock's realm, where art and fire sway, a storm did rage, and mirth was swept away.
The fires in Southern Europe? Or The Little Mermaid?
Okay.
Classic dilemma.
Incorrect.
Yeah.
Continue.
I'll give you another one. Here's your shot of redemption.
Okay.
So heed this tale of song and strife, when nature tested a resoul in life. In Black Rock's desert, trials we must bear, for straw man we cherish and declare.
A straw man?
Roberto, can I help her out?
No, you cannot.
Okay, you're on your own. You got it though.
Like the man that Dorothy meets when she's going down the yellow brick
road. That's not a real news story though. That's just fictional. That's.
Are you locking in that answer?
Lock it in. Lock it in, load it.
Incorrect. The answer is the flood at Burning Man in the desert.
Oh.
Yeah. I knew that one actually.
Why did the Burning Man festival organizer make a terrible firefighter?
Why, Roberto?
Because he kept trying to put out the fire with glitter and good vibes.
Nice.
That's it for segment two.
Yes.
Oh. See you after the break.
Yeah, wait.
Hi, I'm Jamie. Jamie Miller. You probably recognize my voice right now. That could be if you're a fan of my podcast, Young White Man Talks About Movies He's Watched Recently, or maybe you're a fan of my music. You might be one of my 3 monthly listeners on Spotify. Shout out to the Pineapple Gym heads in the audience. I'm here, you know, I'm locked, I'm loaded, and I'm a man looking for love. And that love is Roberto.
Incorrect.
Hey, I'm Patrick, and real glad to be here at RMIT. I was playing cards with the Albanian Mafia and I lost a round and I didn't have the money to pay them because I work as a cafe manager and I have no funds and nothing going for me. So I'm here now. What else do you want to know about me? I do comedy as well. You can catch me at the Adelaide Fringe or the Melbourne Comedy Festival. My name's Patrick Carl with a C. Patrick Carl. I'm funnier than this in my show. Yeah. Anyway, it's real nice to be here. I'm looking forward to going back to my cage.
I hear you like movies. How many movies have you seen?
Probably about 9,000, I would assume.
What was your favorite movie from the year 1972?
Clockwork Orange.
And I hear your favorite movie this year was Sound of Freedom. How many times did you see it in cinemas?
Well, I had to take all the children I kidnapped, but I can only take one by one because otherwise it looks sus. So I saw it 1,000 times.
Correct. The end is nigh. That's the name of our next game. We're going to show you some viral videos and ask you a question. For this first question, either team must bell when they know what this ad is for.
I come up with a drink name, but it's not easy, right? Nowadays with social media, the kids, it's gotta be authentic. How are people gonna connect you with
I'm a girl.
I'm not seeing it.
Ice Spice, my fans are the Munchkins.
Where are you going with this? With a drink name, but it's not easy, right? Now,
red team.
It is Ice Spice with Dunkin' Donuts.
Correct.
Ice Pit Pies with you were called Vanilla Ice Spice. Here I am, I'm with Dunkin'. You go.
Next video.
That's me.
How many times does the baby bash his head?
I thought it was that one avocado for Christmas video, but I want to say 3 times.
Correct.
Who taught you? I think that. Who taught you to do that?
Whoa!
Next video.
I've come across a public faucet. I'm gonna see if it works.
That's me again.
Red team, does the faucet work?
This one does not work.
Incorrect.
I've come across a public faucet. I'm gonna see if it works. Yeah, dog. This one works. Yeah, dog. Let's turn it off. Yeah, dog.
Next video.
The Petticoat 5. It's a computer made by women for women.
So, let's take a look at it. Now, the first thing you notice is the shape of the keys.
That's right. They're designed to make it easier to type with long nails.
Oh, well, that is a good idea. And what is this?
Sorry.
What is the knob for? Red team.
Well, the knob thing, although it looks like a nipple, it is used as a mouse.
Incorrect.
Can we steal?
Yep.
I don't
Red team. No, wait, no.
Blue team, how about you guys go?
Blue
team.
Can you tell?
All right. What do you reckon it's for? Looks like a nipple. I mean, yeah.
Blue team, what is the nub for?
Lock it in, Pat.
Shit, what would I, like, I don't know, just for like playing with during the day? I don't know what women do, to be honest with you. I'm going with that, playing with during the day.
Incorrect.
Damn. And what is this?
Well, that's a place to put your rings.
The nub is for rings. I too have a nub, but not for rings. How inspiring. Goblin, give them your eyes.
Let's go. That's a good comeback.
That is a good comeback. It is honestly
not quite good enough.
Moonlight, you guys won best picture.
Silence. Let us move on to Doom Scroll, our final rapid fire trivia round. Bell in for your answers. Let's go. How much will the new iPhone 15 base model cost? Blue team.
$3,500?
Incorrect.
Roberto.
No.
Red team.
May I ask, is that USD or AUD?
Incorrect.
USD? Wait.
The answer is $1,499. Which celebrity was rumored to be seen at the Al Bakery in Brunswick this year?
Yes.
Red team. Blue team.
Kanye West.
Correct. Which AFL player has been controversially cleared?
Bailey Smith.
Red team.
Bailey Smith.
Incorrect. Which AFL player has been controversially cleared to play in the preliminary final after a high bump which saw his opponent knocked unconscious?
I don't watch sport, but it was...
Blue team.
Calling?
I don't know any players past 1997.
Incorrect. The answer is Braden Maynard. Which American pop star is currently embroiled in a legal dispute for with an Australian fashion designer for using their shared name for their label? Blue team.
Ed Sheeran and Sheen.
Incorrect. The answer is Katy Perry. This week saw an intense manhunt for a convict. this week saw an intense manhunt for a convict who escaped a prison in Pennsylvania, USA. How did he escape?
That was me.
Red team.
Okay. So basically, he like shimmied up a wall and his legs were on one side and his back was on another and he like...
Correct.
Exactly.
Which popular artist released their new album titled Guts earlier this month? Blue team.
Olivia Rodrigo.
Correct.
If you're watching.
Norway's Princess Martha Louise has surprised the world by announcing her marriage to an American shaman. What is the capital of Norway?
What?
Red team.
Canberra?
Incorrect.
Non-existent.
Blue team.
Oslo?
Correct.
Yeah. Good.
What strange item What strange item did a fan hand Pink at her London show?
Ooh.
Red team.
Blue.
Bro thinks he's on the team.
You know, Pink, like.
Incorrect.
Should
we
fucking, I don't know.
Blue team.
Oh, I was gonna say marshmallow.
I could work too.
Incorrect.
Marshmallow.
It was a wheel of brie. Which former Disney teen heartthrob has recently announced he is getting divorced from his actress wife?
Joe Jonas.
Correct.
Exactly.
Which Kardashian is playing a main role in the new American Horror Story season? Red team.
Not red team, blue team. It's Kim Kardashian.
Correct.
Thank you.
Who has decided to save the gorillas for an unexpected TV comeback this week?
Taylor Swift.
Incorrect.
Taylor Swift.
Wait, can I have a rebound on that? Wait, you guys go. Right.
Nothing but net over here.
Save the gorillas for a TV comeback. I don't know why I stepped on the bell. Do you have any idea?
Is that the answer?
No. Someone saved the gorillas.
It's George of the Jungle.
Is it?
Yeah. Brendan Fraser?
Carl Stephan.
No. Incorrect. The answer is Ellen DeGeneres.
Oh, wow.
Making VMA history for most awards won in a single night. How many awards did Taylor Swift take home at this?
Oh, it was nice try.
Red.
It was red, actually. That was 8 awards, Roberto.
Incorrect. It was 9.
I would have given it.
End of round. That is the end of Doom Scroll. Now it is time to reveal our scores. Goblin, tally the eyes.
What?
Hang
on.
What?
Excuse me.
Say what?
I don't know about that.
Can't even count them overall.
Yes. What ones did you guys get right?
What ones didn't we get right?
Okay.
You know what?
JAD.
It's not about the quantity, it's about the quality.
Silence. Time to reveal the score. Here are the scores. Blue team, 10 points. Red team, 6 points. Congratulations, blue team. But that's not enough to save you. That's the end of this week's Locked and Loaded. Players, go back to your cages, and viewers, we'll see you next week. Thank you for watching Locked and Loaded. If you do not continue watching the show every week, we will find you and we will get your eyes and use them to score our points. If you tell other people to watch the show, we will make sure your eyes are spared. Follow us on Instagram and TikTok and YouTube and whatever other social media platforms exist in your world.